explosive. Nam it all! Wow, what was that? Who said Kata Guruma was dead? Look at that off the ground there. Head underneath the...
This is a technique of following on from Kata Guruma to Ukiwaza. In this technique, as you're sacrificing yourself in making the throw, it is not Kata Guruma.
Has to land on the points of the shoulders with force. Yoko Otoshi beautifully executed there by Kakoj. Look at the head drive and the foot drive as well. Everything was good about that.
You've seen so many more of these since the disappearance of the...
Hi, this is Shadi and today we're going to be discussing Kata Guruma and Yoko Sutemi Waza, Ukiwaza or Yoko Otoshi. And before we start anything with this discussion or research that I've done, we need to understand the difference between a hand technique and a sacrificing technique. If you can dump off with your hands and not throw yourself, then it's a hand technique, while if you go down and you need to fully flatten yourself out like here, then it is a sacrificing technique. So I put up a post about my competition example of my techniques and I asked, is this Yoko Otoshi or is this Kata Guruma? And the opinions were mixed. So I learned it from the Olympic champion Fabio Basile, the block with the leg, the pull with the sleeve and the lapel, and really sacrificing yourself sideways, steamrolling on your back in order to get the finish. There's no dumping with your hands. And there's no really loading on the shoulders. So I would call it Yoko Otoshi. Let's see it here in example. Footage courtesy of Judo Fanatics and here the IJF, of course. Link in description. So here you can see it. And blocks with the leg and completely sacrificing himself sideways in order to get the finish. No dumping off with the hands. No loading on the shoulders. Here, if you asked me a while ago, I would say this is Kata Guruma, but... looking at it, especially with the footage of the beginning, in order to finish the throw, you have to fully sacrifice yourself sideways, as Mark Hausinger is doing with this fighting film footage. Link in description, of course. I would say this is a Yoko Otoshi. There's no dumping off with the hands. This is just sticking someone to you and sacrificing yourself fully sideways and not dumping off with your hands and cutting down. Like a Teiwaza as Kata Guruma is. Now, this, it's very beautiful, it's very technical, it requires far less strength than just, you know, standing up and really dumping someone over. Here is further proof that it is a sacrificing technique. He has to crocodile roll when someone offers somewhat of resistance and sprawling. You crocodile roll and get that exposure on the back. Sure, it scores, but it is safe? I wouldn't think so. As opposed to this, which he calls the Hausinga Kata Guruma. Look at that dumping and cutting off with the hands. This is a hand technique, 100%. As opposed to what we saw with Fabio Basile, my example, and the Hausinga example before. Let's see here in competition. So ask yourself this. If you can get the finish without really fully throwing yourself, then it's a hand technique. If you have to fully keep them close to you and just dump yourself in order to get the finish, then it's a sacrificing technique. Here, for example, yes, he throws himself, sacrificing himself, because this is, you know, high-level competition. But can he get the finish with the hands only? Yes. So, for example, here, this is Kata Guruma, an old Kodokan example. You can throw at any direction you may, standing upright, or here, for example, he just throws himself completely backwards. But can he get the dumping without sacrificing himself? Can he finish with his hands only? Yes, but, you know, for the sake of competition, for the sake of scoring upon, Sometimes, obviously, you throw yourself kind of like a serenage or a double leg or any type of technique. Uchimata also, but let's see here. This is a drop Kata Guruma. He can stay upright and finishing only with the hands. And thus, this is Kata Guruma, a hand technique and not a sacrificing technique like Ukiwaza or Yoko Otoshi. Let's see here. Like, this is not what we're doing today. And even if you're sacrificing yourself sideways or forward, doing like a front flip, this is, you know, the loading that gets, that happens before, the control with the hands, the lifting with the hands, all makes it a completely different technique. Now, let's see a modern example of Kata Guruma. I would say this is Kata Guruma. Baruch Shmailov clearly entertained us with this. Look, he pulls, let's see it again slowly. He pulls, creates Kuzushi, drops to his knees, grabs the sleeve, gets up. Look at that lift that he gets with his shoulders and hands, and slams down, cuts down. Obviously, this is high level competition. You have to throw yourself with the throw, kind of like Inoue's Uchimata. But can he finish it without sacrificing himself? Yes. This is a hand technique. I would call this Kata Guruma 100%. Very rarely the people that can do this. If you can do like Denis Zanikov here's example, then congratulations, but I don't see it happening very rarely. Maybe Pantano's example can be a testament to that, but not many can actually do this. So you really have to go under and really like cut down with your hands, and sacrificing himself here, obviously, for the sake of scoring Ippon. But can he finish it standing up? Yes, because he clearly got that lift. Now, let's go to our grappling cousins, the Greco-Roman wrestlers. They have the same issue. They have the same controversy. Here, he gets the cut with his hands, gets that lift off his knees and his shoulders and arms, you know, full body lift, and gets that finish. Is this a sacrificing technique? I wouldn't say so. I would say this is a hand technique, the way he cuts with his hands and shoulders. And he can also finish it, you know, keeping upright. While this example here, Greco-Roman Olympic champion Jung of Korea, he has to fully sacrifice himself in order to finish the throw. There's no hand technique involved. He's not cutting down with the hands. He's just using his hands to keep someone close to him. So we really need to distinguish with the finish. The finish is really everything. So do you absolutely have to sacrifice yourself? Then it's a Sutemi Waza. It's not a Kata Guruma. But if you can stay upright and finish it with your hands, then I would say it's Kata Guruma. So here you can see he's explaining that you have to keep them close to you, gripping the hand and really keep them close, blocking with the leg and fully sacrificing himself, throwing the opponent forward as an Ukiwaza, and not so much dumping with the shoulders. Now, this is Yoko Otoshi. I want you to pay close attention to the leg that's blocking. He gets deep under to the point where Uke's ankle is almost at the crotch level of Tori. That's how deep you get into their face and drop down and block with the leg. What happens is, look at Tori's torso, how he completely flattens himself out in order to finish the throw. And that's what we have a lot these days. This is Kodokan's competition example of Yoko Otoshi. And look, a lot of people today would call this Kata Guruma, but in fact it's not. He blocks with the legs and completely throws himself sideways in order to finish the throw. Can you get that fully standing? I wouldn't say so. That would be a completely different technique. He would be lifting off the shoulders. This technique is not because of the leg band. That's what a lot of people need to know. Johan Latz did this. Justin Flores did this. Flavio Canto did this. So a lot of people actually were doing this far before the leg band. So we need to understand a few points here. You can start off just like that early example at the beginning of the video. He gripped as in Kata Guruma, but fully sacrificed himself, turning it into a Sutemi Waza and not so much Kata Guruma. It's the same as an Uchimata. Letting go of the lapel becomes Uchimata Makikomi, a Sutemi Waza. You can start with a single leg as a wrestler and then finishing off with a double leg in order to get the throw. So it's not really as the beginning of what's happening, but really as the finish. But if you can actually finish off without sacrificing yourself because of the high level of the competition, then in my opinion, it remains a teiwaza. It's kind of like the drop serenage. This is a very detailed topic, and it's full of gray. It's full of gray and not so much black and white. So that's why the whole controversy. I would say if you can finish without sacrificing yourself, then it's a teiwaza, it's a kata guruma. But if you really need to flatten yourself out in order to get the finish, then it's either an ukiwaza or a yoko otoshi. And also yoko otoshi, ukiwaza, there's no lift, but if you can get that lift, that huge lift on the shoulders using your hands, and then from there cutting down, then it's kata guruma, like Baruch Shmailov's example, and Denis Zenikov and Pantano. So if you have anything else to add, let me know down below. This was Shadi, and thank you for listening.